don't bring me down. Don't bring me down. Don't bring me down. Hey guys, it's Rochelle and welcome back to my channel. I'm back with another one for you guys, and today I'm gonna be doing this look right here. So I'm gonna show you guys this hair tutorial and this makeup tutorial. A lot of you guys have been requesting me to include my makeup in my hair tutorials, so here it is. And I'm basically gonna be going from 0 to 100. So if you want to see how I achieve this look from start to finish, then please continue to watch. All right, so first things first, before I beat my face, I'm gonna do my hair. So I'm gonna be rocking the RPG Show wig today. This is one of their newest wig. So this is what the packaging looks like. This is what it looks like on the inside. You get two wig caps, elastic band, and this is the wig out of packaging. It's a really bright, like icy blonde, like platinum blonde hair. And the lace on this wig, it's Swiss lace. I will say that this lace is amazing. Like it's really, really bomb lace. Like it melts down so good. So this is what the wig looks like on the inside. It comes with three combs, so two on the side and one on the back. Now you could just put the wig on your head, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna do a little tweezing. I know tweezing can be annoying, but I tried the wig on. I didn't really love how the hairline looked, especially at the sides. So I'm gonna go in and do a bit of tweezing just to make it look a little bit more realistic, like give it more of a realistic hairline for myself. As for the tweezing, you guys have seen me doing this plenty of time with my wigs. I also have a very detailed video on how I customize the hairline, so I'm gonna link that video in the description bar down below. So I always just tweeze behind the hairline and make sure the hair is a little bit damp. So you wanna go ahead and wet the hair up before you start tweezing. Now as for the knots, they're very, very light. So when I do have the wig on, you're gonna be able to see how white they are because it doesn't really go with my skin tone. So I'm just gonna put my wig back on my canvas head, grab some foundation powder. This is my foundation powder from MAC. You can use any foundation powder, and I'm just going to darken that up a little bit. Now you can tint the lace, but I didn't wanna get the hair all wet by dyeing the knots to like a skin tone color. And I just wanted to make this video very easy and beginner friendly. So yeah, this is how the wig is looking now on my head. And I'm just gonna go ahead and apply her down. I'm gonna go ahead and apply my lace glue on my forehead. The glue that I'm using is the Ghost Bond glue. All the hair info, like always, will be in the description bar down below. And you gotta let that glue dry clear and then pull the lace down. And I'm gonna go in with my rat tail comb and my blow dryer and just melt that lace down. So I'm just speeding this part up of the video, because like I said, I do have a very detailed video on applying my wig. So I'm just gonna go in with my scissors and just start cutting off that excess lace because I won't be needing this lace anymore. And if you're a beginner or new to wigs, you can definitely wear this wig glueless. If you attach the elastic band to it and tighten it enough, you can rock this wig glueless as well. I mean, it's not gonna look as melted, but you can wear her glueless. And you can also do the got to be free spray method or the olive oil, which is the glueless method in applying your wig. I have a video on that already. So I'm literally just gonna go in with my tweezer and I'm just gonna fix that part up a little because I didn't like the way it was looking. Now I'm gonna go in with my hot comb and some hair serum. So I'm gonna apply this Ion hair serum silk drops, a couple drops into the hair, because guys, I will be honest with you, this wig was a bit dry. She was a little like thirsty, like she needed some attention. I have worn RPG Show wigs in the past, but I will say like this blonde one was a bit on the dry side. Now I'm gonna go in with my hot comb and just flatten it down so my hair doesn't look as lumpy and bumpy on the top. And this is pretty much all I'm gonna do for the hair for now, and I'm just gonna move on to makeup because with this hair, we need a full glam. We gotta beat this face. I'm gonna go in with my favorite primer. This is the Milk Hydro Primer, and I'm using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I use two primers. I go in with my Milk Primer first. So really, this one is just to ensure that my makeup lasts all day long, and trust me, it works. Then I go in with my Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I mainly use this on my nose area. So I mainly use it on my nose and by my nose because on that area, I have a bit of texture. You can see my pores, and it just smooths out the pores and the texture in my skin. Now I'm gonna go in with my favorite brow pencil. This is my Ride or Die. I've been using this forever. This is the Benefit Cosmetics
my Precisely Brow Pencil in the shade number 4. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill in the bottom of my brows. I usually do the bottom and then I do the top after. Now to carve up my brows, I'm going to go ahead and use some concealer. I'm using my Too Faced concealer. It's my Ride or Die. And I'm going to go ahead and shape up and carve up my brows. Give the illusion of nice, clean, sharp brows. Make it look like I got my brows done recently. Guys, I have not done my brows in like 4 months. And it's harder to fill them in when I haven't done them in that long. I mean, they don't look crazy hairy or anything, but I haven't done them in forever. Anyways, I'm just putting that concealer all over my eyelid. It's going to act as a base for my eyeshadow. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply my translucent powder. And I'm getting it literally all over my face. So go ahead, pat that powder in, and it's going to lock that concealer into place. All right, so I'm going to use the KKW Beauty Matte Eyeshadow Palette. I love these shades. I love matte shades. I love worn tones. And these colors are colors that I've seen before. Like, you've seen colors like this in other palettes. So you don't have to have this palette to create this look. I'm going to go in with that warm brown shade and pop that into my crease and pull it out. So I'm going to pull it out because I want to give my eyes an elongated cat-like shape. I mean, they kind of look catty already, but I want to, you know, make them look a little bit extreme. So I'm going to go in with the darker brown eyeshadow and pop that into the crease as well. I'm using a very small defined brush. This is from Makeup Addiction. It's really going to carve out the crease. Going back into my concealer, I'm going to go ahead and carve out that lid. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply these two shades. So I kind of mix them together and I'm going to pat it all over my eyelid. And you guys, I lost the rest of the clip. I don't know what happened. But yeah, I just pat it onto my lid. So let's move on. So I'm going to grab this dark brown eyeshadow. It's the darkest one in the palette. And I'm going to create a wing liner. So you want to get yourself an angle brush and apply to your lash line and the outer corner of your eyes. I'm going to go back into the palette and I'm going to grab these two brown shades, mix them together and apply it at the outer corner and just pull that into the crease. And then I'm just going to go in with a blending brush just to blend out any harsh lines. Now I'm going to use my favorite Ride or Die black liner and I'm just going to line the lash line. So I'm not going to create a wing liner. I'm just going to line the lash line so that way when I put my lashes on, you can't see the lash band. So just add some mascara to my lashes, my teeny lashes, and I'm going to use Lily Lashes in Miami. These are my current favorite Lily Lashes, the Miami lashes. And to create a sharp, clean line, I'm going to go in with my concealer. And the brush that I'm using is by Colored Rain. I'm not sure if this is an eyeshadow brush or a concealer brush, but I love this brush for applying my concealer. I never skip this step when I'm doing my makeup. I'm gonna apply my concealer. It is a orange tone and it's to color correct. I have dark circles. I don't know if you guys can see them clearly. I feel like you can see them very clearly because I just got a new lens recently and you can see everything. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply that concealer and then I'm gonna go ahead and apply my concealer from Too Faced. This is in the shade Warm Sand. This is how I've been doing my foundation lately. So I literally just apply concealer in the areas that I want to highlight. This concealer is not super light. It's almost similar to my foundation shade. Now I'm gonna go in with a dark foundation. This is the MAC Studio Fix Fluid in, I believe this is NC50. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply my contour. So I applied at the hollows of my cheek, along my forehead, down the side of my nose. This is how we're gonna snatch his face. And the foundation that I'm using is the MAC Pro Longwear Foundation. Now I'm gonna go ahead and blend in my concealer first. So I'm using the Colored Rain sponge. This is like their beauty sponge. You have to use it damp and I'm gonna blend in that concealer. Now under my contour, I'm using foundation in that area. So that's mainly where I apply the foundation. So I'm really just applying mainly concealer and doing contour and a little bit of foundation on my face. So I'm gonna go ahead and blend out that nose highlight and that nose contour. The brush that I'm using to blend out the contour is by Zoeva. I've had it forever. Now to set and lock my concealer, I'm gonna use the Anastasia Beverly Hills powder in the shade Banana. And I'm gonna go ahead and pat that under the eye. So I'm not gonna bake it, I'm just patting the powder in. And then I go in with my MAC Studio Fix powder in the shade NC42. And I'm gonna go ahead and pat and make sure that everything is locked in and secure. And then I'm gonna go in with my bronzer, Matte Mineralized Skin Finish, and apply to the hollows of my cheek and snatch some cheekbones and apply it along my forehead. Take my favorite blush, Peaches by MAC, and apply it to the apples of my cheeks. And then I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Beauty highlighter. I can't remember which name this was. but it's my first time using it. I will put the name in the description box, but bitch, I was feeling myself. Like, this highlighter, it's so gorgeous. It gives the skin a really nice wet look, and I'm here for that. And I'm just gonna apply a bit of that at the inner corner of my eyes and also on my nose. Now I'm gonna go ahead and finish off the brows. So I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills brow powder, and I'm gonna go ahead and fill in the top of my brows now because the face is pretty much completed. I just have to finish up the eyebrows and the eyes. So I took the darkest brown eyeshadow from the palette and I run it along my bottom lash line, and I use the eyeliner pencil from MAC Teddy to line my waterline. It's the pencil in Teddy, and it's a nice brown shade. And then I'm gonna finish it off by applying some mascara to the bottom lashes. Okay guys, so this hair, as you can see, it's super blonde. And this hairline was kind of bothering me. So I went back in with my tweezer and I tweezed it up a bit more. I just felt like the hairline needed more work, and I went ahead and I cut some very tiny, tiny, very natural like baby hair, and I went in with my hair mousse and my edge brush just to give it more of a realistic hairline. I know it's not super realistic, it is blonde hair, there's no roots on it. And yeah, so I had to go in and just make it look a little bit more realistic. I don't like when the hairline looks super duper straight. I also don't like too much baby hair, but a little is fine for me. So yeah, I'm just gonna go in with the foam and just flatten it down a bit. Now that I pulled out some edges onto this wig, I'm happy with how she's looking. So I'm gonna finish off my makeup. I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips with my favorite lip pencil, Cork by MAC. And then I went in with this lipstick and I was just like, no, this is not gonna work. So I went in with this like nude peach shade from the KKW collection. It's from their 90s collection. I believe this lipstick is called 90s, not sure. But I'm gonna go ahead and apply this onto my lips, and I'm gonna be using the It's My Riri brush. I'm not sure if this is a lip brush or not. And then I went in with just a little bit of lip gloss and I wasn't really feeling it. So I just kept the lips on the matte side. So yeah, this is the completed look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment down below. Let me know what you think of the makeup and hair tutorial. Let me know if you want me to do more makeup tutorial in my hair tutorial. And I'll definitely do that. And I'll see you guys in another video very, very soon. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Love you. Bye.